We want to perform division by a decimal. So the first step is to write this in long division form. So the first example will have 1.1 divided by 0.6. We don't want to perform the division in this form. We want to make our divisor a whole number. So we're going to move the decimal point one place to the right to here, and we can do this as long as we do the same to our dividend. So we'll move this decimal point one place to the right as well to here. And the result of this division problem will be the same as the result from the division involving the decimals. Let's go ahead and rewrite this so it's a little bit easier to interpret. This is going to be 11 divided by 6, where the decimal point would be here for 11, which will move up into our quotient. And now we'll divide as we normally do. So we first want to determine how many 6s there are in 11. That'll be 1. 1 times 6 is 6, and now we subtract. 11 minus 6 is 5. Now, one of the things we have to be aware of when dividing with decimals, we need to keep dividing until this decimal either terminates, meaning it stops, or it starts to repeat with a pattern. So to keep dividing, what we're going to have to do is add zeros to the right of the decimal point. If we add a zero here, it's not going to change the value of 11, so we can bring this zero down and keep dividing. And now we want to determine how many 6s there are in 50. That would be 8. 8 times 6 is 48, and we subtract. This difference would be 2. We need to add another 0 and bring it down. So now we want to determine how many 6s there are in 20. That would be 3. 3 times 6 is 18, and we subtract. This difference is 2, the same as we had before. Add another 0, bring it down. How many 6s in 20? It's still 3. 6 times 3 is 18, and we subtract. Notice how we get a difference of 2 again. So if we added another 0, this would be 20 again, resulting in another 3. So the 3 is repeating. So the way we write this quotient would be 1.8. And since the 3 repeats, we write the 3 with a bar over it. And it's important that we don't put this bar over the 8, because notice how the 8 is not repeating, only the 3. Let's take a look at a second example. Here we have 5 divided by 0.11. So in long division form, we'd have 5 divided by 0.11. To make the divisor a whole number, we'll have to move the decimal point 1, 2 places to the right. So we must do the same to the dividend. Right now the decimal point is here. So we move it to the right 2 places, we're going to have to add some zeros, 1, 2, making this 500. So now this division problem becomes 500 divided by 11, with a decimal point here moved up into the quotient, just in case we have to add extra zeros on the end here. Now we'll determine how many 11s there are in 50. That would be 4. 4 times 11 is 44. We subtract. That's going to be 6. Bring down the next digit, which is 0. How many 11s in 60? That's going to be 5. 5 times 11 is 55. We subtract. That's going to be 5. Again, we can't stop here, so we have to start adding zeros to the right of this decimal point. So this becomes 50. How many 11s in 50? Well, we asked that question earlier. That was 4. 4 times 11 is 44. The difference is 6. Add another 0 and bring it down. How many 11s in 60? Again, we asked that before as well. That's 5. 5 times 11 is 55. We subtract. That's going to be 5. Add a 0. And now we're back at 50 again. So what we should notice here is that the 45 is repeating. So the way we'll express this is 45.45 repeating. Notice how now the bar is going to go over both the 4 and the 5, because both digits are repeating.